That is it.
The Russian Wings against the Boston Bruins. But these people are here to see a fellow who won't be out on the ice tonight or ever again. He's Bobby Orr. Hello, I'm Robin Young, and Bobby Orr wore the Bruins 4 for over a decade. He was blessed with phenomenal talent and damned with bad knees. Finally, the legs have given out, number 4 is going up in the rafters, and we'll cheer Bobby Orr for the last time.
You hear a lot about we're four, but we're 4-4. I'm Marty Sender. Also on our show this evening, Dave Maynard and the Phantom Diner will give us their opinions of Yi Xing. That's a restaurant in Cambridge. In our health department, Dr. Jim Wasko will talk about programs and information available for mastectomy patients. In Discovery's Joyce Kilhawick's going to talk about playing squash. And we'll listen to the wonderful music and have a rare television appearance of Billy Joel, perhaps the hottest musician, piano player, composer, lyricist in the country. He truly is an exceptional talent. And now let's go back to the story of an even more exceptional talent on ice, Bobby Orr.
Well, this is where it all started, back in 1966, when he was an 18-year-old rookie from Parry Sound, Ontario. And tonight, this is where it will end. They'll retire the number 4 and the guy who wore it, ending the career of perhaps the greatest player ever to don a pair of skates, Bobby Orr.
Of course it won't end. Legends never do. They'll still be talking about the Stanley Cups, the MVP awards, the pirouettes, and the class. But today the governor has declared it Bobby's Day. Most of all, they'll be saying goodbye.
And Bobby Orr! This day would ultimately come. We all just hoped it wouldn't come as soon. And Bobby has accepted the fact that he no longer will play in the game that he loves, in the game he made universal, as the number one player that ever donned a pair of skates. Number 4, Bobby Orr.
Did you ever question the irony that on the one hand, you were blessed with this incredible talent, and on the other hand, a bad knee?
Well, you know, in a contact game, you know, injuries, you know, they're going to happen. And it just happens I've got one of those knees. I don't feel like I'm cheated. I spent 10 years here, and my third year in Chicago now, and I've been rewarded greatly, and I don't feel cheated.
Bobby spent most of the day at parties and ceremonies like these. He has a lot of friends who are politicians. But politicians are just like everybody else when it comes to Bobby Orr. They are all humbled in his presence.
Thank you.
It's awfully young to be a hero.
Well, I don't consider myself a hero, Robin. I love to play. I was being rewarded very well for playing, and I love to do it. And when you can put the combination together, you love something, you're getting paid very well for it. And the thrills and the people you meet. And today, I could never forget today.
And neither would the other friends that Bobby made sure were invited to his parties. And that's the other thing about Bobby Orr. His devotion to charitable organizations is legend, and so is his devotion to his friends.
You know, I have a very good friend here in Boston. Her name is Deanna DeLady. And she had polio as a child, and she's confined to a wheelchair and so on. And she's the strongest little thing I've ever seen, ever met. And anytime I got big-headed or started feeling sorry for myself, you know, Dee was always a great inspiration to me.
This is the the skating that caught the eye of a Bruins scout when Bobby was just 12. At 18, he was on the team and on his way to becoming the highest scoring defenseman in NHL history and the first defenseman to lead the league in scoring.
My style is a style that coaches coaching young boys hate. No offense to defensemen, I carry the puck. The teams here in Boston that I played on, they knew I was going to carry the puck a lot, and they did a lot of covering up for me.
Then in 1970, with 40 seconds of overtime left, Bobby clinched the Bruins' first Stanley Cup triumph in 29 years, scoring the final goal. He would do the same in 72.
If you're a hockey player, the Stanley Cup's the thing that you're aiming at. Baseball players, the World Series, and football, the Super Bowl. And I don't think you can ever get used to it. It's so much fun and it's such a thrill. You just should want more.
But that was not to be. When the knees started to go, the Bruins hedged on a high-priced contract, which Orr eventually got with the Chicago Blackhawks. Ironically, he hadn't cashed a single paycheck when he quit 2 years later in 1978.
Do you feel, though, that after all the dust settled, did Boston sell you out? Did the Bruins sell you out?
Well, that's 3 years ago, and I made the decision. They have a business to run here, and they're going to run it the way they thought they should.
I remember reading at one point that there were tears of frustration as a rookie. Were there tears of frustration as a veteran when you realized there's nothing you can do about it?
The day I had to stand up and say that I've finished for good, it was a very difficult thing to do. But I've had a lot of time to think about it, and it's made it a little bit easier. I'll tell you, you couldn't ask for anything more. I mean, what the people have given me here and how they've treated me, nobody could possibly want or ask it for anything more.
In this building, or in any hockey rink, anywhere in the world, the man who definitely needs no introduction, number four, Bobby Orr.
That's the way it was all that night at the Boston Garden. They cheered Bobby, his wife Peggy, for a solid half an hour. It was an amazing outpouring of affection.
Painful to think back?
Yeah.
No, I'd love to think back and go over the old days. When I went to the Bruin camp, I can still remember the first day going in and walked through the door, and there's this big guy sitting on the bed, and I recognized him. It was Johnny Busick, and I said, hi, Mr. Busick. And he said, no, he says, you don't call me Mr. Busick. He said, you call me John or Chief. But I can still remember. Oh, my gosh. I think you have to look at the Stanley Cups. Teddy Green's comeback to me was one of the, I don't think many people could have done that, but what Teddy did, the night did. We traded for Carol Vadney, Phil Esposito's 78th goal. There's so much. The Boston fan. I know how I remember the city. I always be back. I wish I could have stayed longer. How any player on our team could go to any other player and say, hey, you're not pulling your load.
Brad Park. Brad, I wish I could have played with you longer.
Okay, my old roomie.
Well, some Donnie, Marcotti. Cash, thank you.
No, thank you, Bobby Orr. We'll be back in a moment. Our departments are next here on TV4's Evening Magazine.
It ranked Notre Dame.
Bobby Orr!